Well, looks like I predicted this. Well, you predicted it.
No, I didn't.
And in honor of this victory last night.
Thanks for the times that you've given me.
Hear that? Thank you for the times you've given me.
Kyle Busch!
The memories of all the wins.
How many, 46 of them?
46 in my career.
Three in a row. Oh, wait.
And now
I've just begun
to the end
of my rainbow, so I can
taste the Skittles.
Woo! Taste the rainbow.
Something is Kyle here?
Wouldn't that be amazing?
It would be amazing if he could sing the chorus. Welcome, Kyle.
You once, twice.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Three times. A race winner in a row.
You've been a little hostile.
And I love
winning. So that's what I'll do.
Over and over again.
Yes, you won.
I'm once. I'm twice.
Okay. I think they got it. Do you guys got it?
Three times in a row, race winners.
All right.
And I will continue to dominate.
Okay.
That's not me saying it. That's him. I mean, I.
Well, thanks, Kyle. I mean,
Kyle, you stay on set.
Yeah, he's gonna stay in camera.
He's gonna stay in camera.
Welcome back to No Onions, No Tomatoes. We are here to break down Richmond. Last night we had a interesting race.
Interesting.
It didn't rain.
Oh, beautiful
weather. Was great over there in Virginia.
Not a lot of cautions until about 50 laps to go.
I mean, did Goodyear, like, were these tires made out of, like, the big wheel material, like, that never get flat? Like, we didn't have any of that. These guys ran around literally for 355 laps before there was a caution.
How did the race start off? Let's not jump to the end where Cal wins.
You already did that. Oh, he did it. Kyle, show off.
Let's start at the beginning.
All right, so Martin Truex is the beginning.
Yes, and so he's on pole, but where did Kyle start?
32nd.
32nd. How long did it take him to get to the top 10?
No, it's like two laps.
34 laps. He was passing cars like...
He passed a car a lap almost, and next thing you know, he's running in the top 10. What also helped was that there was no caution within that first run.
Right.
100 lap first stage, right?
Stage 100 laps.
No caution, no pits. Guys are just running around.
And only one person short pitted.
But yes.
We kept thinking, when are they going to do green flag pits? No one did them.
No, nobody did them. Because of the big wheel tires by Goodyear.
But Logano sort of went to the lead in stage one.
Yes.
And we talked about last week where he had no... Playoff points.
No playoff points. Finally gets a playoff point by winning stage one.
That's right. And so at the end of stage one, we have Logano, Almirola.
Almirola was strong, man.
Yes. Kurt Busch, also strong. William Byron.
Young poet.
He's a poet.
Is he a poet?
Well, yes, I think so.
Okay.
Boyer. And by the end of stage one, Kyle Busch is in sixth place.
Chase Elliott,
Dylan, and Truex has fallen to ninth.
Hey.
And Harvick is in 10th.
Obviously, he didn't have a good long run car.
Right. Harvick. And so, it's like we said, Logano's first stage win, first playoff
points. And remember, we talked to you guys about Richmond last year. He gets the win there, but then it's encumbered. So, you're looking at this going, uh-oh, this guy's on a mission to win this whole thing.
That's right.
Domination. Stage
Bubba,
two.
Bubba gets the free pass after stage one. So, stage two is another 100 laps.
Yes.
Again, Boyer is saying, hey, I want to play.
Yeah.
I want to play around this year.
Hey,
so he goes to the lead.
Yeah.
In about lap 169. But then Logano says, you know what? I need to take control of this track.
Absolutely. And again, this is another caution-free stage. Another 100 laps, no cautions.
So with about 8 laps to go in stage two, Logano goes back to the lead. So at the end of stage two, you have Logano, Boyer, Almirola, Kurt Busch, Byron, Kyle, Newman, Kozlowski, Truex, and Harvick.
Kozlowski made an appearance. Awesome.
Yes.
Whew, so then, now we're going into stage three, right? So you know we got 200 laps to run. we know that we're going to have some pit stops. Mm-hmm. It's impossible to go 200 laps on big wheel tires.
Stuck on the big wheel tires, it makes me laugh. But here's the thing. At the end of stage two, you had your pit stops. Some people had some penalties.
Ooh.
Harvick, thrown equipment. I hadn't seen this one before.
Okay, so Harvick's team, his pit crew is inventing ways to get penalties, like ways that you would never think of. So he makes a wedge adjustment. The tire carrier does. And instead of carrying the wrench over to the other side, he literally throws it into the groin of a pit crew member on the other side of the wall. That's going to be a penalty, bro.
What? What did I do?
Mess, man.
And so, you know, where he had been in the top 10, he has to serve his pit penalty, as does Kyle Larson and AJ Allmendinger.
These guys are losing tires. Tires are rolling away.
Uncontrolled. But so the final stage starts with Logano, Kurt Busch, Byron. Kyle has moved up to two spots. His pit crew really is the hero.
Ooh, they were rolling.
And Boyer's fifth. Yes. So anyway, we had a lot of drivers leading laps.
Seven
different leaders. So let's just break that down about who led how many laps.
Okay.
So we have Martin Truex led 121 laps.
121 laps. I mean, you know what?
How many laps is it total?
It's 400. 400 laps. But the crazy thing about that is that neither one of those led to him winning a stage.
No.
Because he didn't have a good long run car.
But Logano, who won both stages, had 92 laps.
Yep. Kurt Busch,
98.
Yep.
How about Boyer?
45.
And so then Kyle, as we talked about, he was mired like in sixth place or whatever for a long time, sixth, fourth, and then it was really Harvick, Boyer, and Truex kind of fighting it out.
Yes.
And then the caution started coming.
Caution free.
For 350 laps.
Yes. There hadn't been a caution free race since 2002 at Talladega. So we're looking at history's getting ready to be made, and all of a sudden, the buffoonery starts.
I like the buffoonery.
Yes.
Okay, so, well, we also had some green flag. We did have to green flag pit stop during that final stage.
For sure.
So, and we had people hitting walls. Jimmy hit the wall in stage one. Stenhouse hits it, but still no cautions. Until that lap 355 or something. And so, Blaney. What's up with poor Blaney?
I love YRB, but he just seems to just be in the wrong place at the wrong time a lot. And I think some of it is just where he's placing his car and the chances that he's taking. So that's something I think he's going to need to work on. He has the equipment, he has the talent, just in the wrong place at the wrong time. Constantly. Stop it.
So he gets into it with Stenhouse.
Imagine
and
that.
He ends up finishing 22nd for the day. Blaney does.
Amazing.
And so we finally have some caution stops.
Yes.
And so we have Truex, Harvick, and Kyle Busch come out 1, 2, 3 after that. Now Truex.
Yes.
Who led the most laps, I believe.
Champ.
Has never won at short track.
Well, you know, the thing with him, it's been, last year was, you can only win on cookie cutters. You can only win on mile and a half. And, you know, I guess you don't consider Phoenix a short track, even though it's a mile, a little over a mile. But yeah, any of the under a mile tracks he has not won on. And that's something he's going to need to fix.
Yes. And so we go back, green flag racing, another caution.
Boom.
Like they always say, cautions breed cautions.
Yeah.
So Kurt Busch.
That line's been played out. Thanks a lot, DW.
So Kurt Busch kind of has McMurray go up into the wall. And so then McMurray and Larson.
Wait a minute, they're teammates.
Yeah,
Chip Ganassi, they're teammates, right?
I was kind of giggling because, yeah. So Larson goes by McMurray to get the free pass.
Right.
McMurray's feelings are hurt about that.
Yeah, he's all in his feelings.
Man. And so he's bumping Larson on under caution.
He's bumping his own teammate. It's ridiculous. And I'm going to tell you something about, listen.
Nah.
If you have a problem with your teammate, you don't settle that on the track. That needs to be settled back in the garage area or, you know, back when you guys are going over the race as a team on Monday. Not on the track. That was a bad look for Jamie McMurray.
Newman goes to the garage. Everyone pits.
Right.
Here's where it all went wrong.
Woo! Didn't Truex good.
Truex just had awful pit stops. He went in third and comes out of the top 10.
Something that would never happen again. The tire knocking down.
The tire, he's pulling off the tire. It hits the jack and causes the jack to collapse.
Never. Freak. It was a freak accident.
You can't make it happen again if
nope,
you tried.
Nope, can't replicate it.
Okay, so we go green flag racing again.
Right.
More cautions.
Yeah.
There was four cautions in the last 25 or 50 laps.
Absolutely.
And so, by the end of the day...
I mean, at the end of the day, let's just get to it. Kyle Busch is leading the race, okay? He is leading the right 32 laps. At the end, he's leading. Restart. This, to me, was one of his best performances for coming from 32nd place and holding these guys off on three different restarts, including a green-white checker. He went out there, won that race. I don't care if he only led 32. He was dominant. It was a dominant 32, if you ask me, and a total team win.
All right, and so then let's just follow up with the winning order.
Yeah.
So Kyle, of course, is first. Chase Elliott.
So you talk about needing a good run. He needed a good run.
He needed a good run, and this is his, like, 8th second place finish.
Okay.
Denny Hamlin, Joey Logano, Harvick, Jimmy Johnson recovered from that earlier issue where he went down the lap.
Mm-hmm.
Kyle Larson, pit issues. Brad Keselowski, Clint Bowyer, and look at Daniel Suarez.
Daniel Suarez, that's a big one for him and that team. He's another that's had some bad luck over the last few weeks, and then also doing it with a fractured thumb.
That's right. And then Truex ended up finishing 14th.
Yeah, that's
even though, and like we said, he had the most laps led of the race with 120.
Yeah, he did. And hey, this race took 3 hours. It went relatively quick. It would have went quicker if we wouldn't have those caution laps at the end of the race. But it was a fluid race, on and on and on, and we got through it. It was rather entertaining because we had different leaders, and I don't mind when you click off laps. It's a good thing. So kudos to them. Kudos to Kyle Busch again. Kudos definitely to Chase Elliott. Let's look at the point standings.
All right, point standings.
Point standings. So Kyle Busch is leading right now, and just he has now 17 playoff points. And again, want to reinforce this to you guys. Those points transfer through to the chase in each round. And also, he's in first place. The driver who wins at the end of the 26 races with the most points will take an extra 15 points. So he's looking at taking at least 32 points into...
If the season ended... Because how far away is it?
We are a quarter through the season. We're 9 races through. We got 36, right? And then we have 26. It's 26 total races until we get to the chase. So we have 17 races left. We're almost halfway there.
That's right.
So guys need to get going. But out of those 9, shoots, we have 2 drivers that have 3 wins. And then we have 3 other winning. We don't have a lot of winners. The competition at the top is really, really tight. Go out there to win a race, and you're going to have to be dominant.
So that means those points that you're winning during the race for your standing is going to be good because 16 go through. If you win a race, you go automatically through if you're in the top 30.
But right now,
we only have 5 winners.
Yeah.
So there's a lot of spots to fill based on points. Point your way in.
I don't think there's going to be more than 9 winners by the time we hit the chase. But that's just my prediction. So hey, do you want to go to the bucket of questions?
Yeah, really quick.
By the way,
this is my I voted for Let the Rabbit Eat Shrimps from our previous episode. I told you I kept it.
All right, best superhero. Let's do this one quick.
Okay, best superhero.
Yep.
Oh, you go.
Oh, no. You know what? I think we did this one before. It's a retread, man.
Oh, boy.
Can't be doing that,
man. Oh, my God. Hurry up.
I'm going. Best candy bar.
Reese's Peanut Butter Cups.
Oh, come on. Oh, well, that's a good one.
Reese's
Snickers. Peanut. Snickers stands the test of time.
M&M's. I forgot. M&M's.
Oh, goodness. Thanks a lot for tuning in to No Onions, No Tomatoes. Make sure you guys follow us on Twitter, Facebook, and on YouTube. Subscribe.
Thanks to our special guest star, Kyle Busch.
Absolutely. You guys have a good one. Talladega, the biggest and the baddest next week. And we will be breaking that one down from a fundamental standpoint. See you later.
Peace out.